Hello to everyone. Before I share to you the message that the Lord put in my heart, I would like to thank each one of you who are here today and also those who are watching this broadcast at home, in their living room, wherever they are. I would like to thank you for praying for my family, praying for my children, and most especially, of course, this ministry. Thank you for your support, and thank you for your prayers. And in the next 30 minutes, I would like to share to every one of you, or I'd like to share to each one of you about the personality and characteristic of an eagle, as you saw that on the screen. The eagle is a symbol used many times in scripture. Okay, and in fact, it has been mentioned 38 times in the Bible, or throughout the Bible. We can learn some important lessons from this majestic creation of God. Eagles have a wingspan of 2 meters. You know how wide the wings of an eagle, and are around 90 centimeters tall. The eagle mates for life. Let me say that again. The eagle mates for life and use the same nests for life. They stick together, you know, the relationships. And once they build their nests, they stay there for life. They use the same nest for life. What does it imply on that picture right there? This nest is built in a safe place, often on the ledge of the sharp cliff. It is built to last, and the largest nest reported is 9.5 feet, or 9.5 feet wide and 20 feet deep. So that is big. 9.5 feet wide, so that long, and then 20 feet deep, so twice or three times my size. So that's the nest, that's the house, or the safety, the protection, and how the eagle protect the eaglets. When the babies are born, both parents assume responsibility for their care. Both parents, okay, the mom and the pops of the eagles, they're the one who assume the responsibility for their care. They are gentle parents sitting on the eggs for 1 month. The parents bring food to the nests and feed them small pieces of meat. Within 45 days, they can weigh nearly 40 times their birth weight. At 3 months, they get the special feathers for flying, and new learning experience begins. The mother eagle flies into the nest and begins to thrush around, causing a great commotion. Eventually, one of the babies will fall out of the nest and begin heading for the earth below. Never having used the wings before. So what happened was, the eagle will remove those cushions. Remember, around the nest of the eagle, the nest of an eagle, there's a frame there. According to those people who seen this nest, the nest was made of thorns. Around that nest, there were some thorns. And what will happen was, the mother will remove those cushions so that one day those eaglets wouldn't be too comfortable, in staying in that nest. So the tendency is for them to get out of that nest and probably standing there at the edge of the nest. But what they want is to, they want to fly, of course, because that's their made of. That's they are made of. So the mother will actually or eventually push that eaglets and let them fall towards the ground. But the moment that this eaglets will fall to the ground or hit the ground, the mother will just fly and scoop them up and bring back to the nest. Eventually, one of the babies will fall out of the nest and begin heading for the earth below. Never having used his wings before, he's not really sure what to do. Okay? Because this is new to them. They don't know what to do. So, of course, they need the help of the mother. Come on, guys. Look at me here. Look at me here. There are so many children today that had been they're confused and they don't know what to do because there's no guidance. They just left, the parents just leave them and they don't have any supervision. And if these kids or these teenagers don't know the Lord, what will happen? They end up using drugs, hooked up on drugs, or maybe hooked or going with wrong people, and end up in jail. And sometimes, not even end up in jail. Sometimes their life has been so miserable, and their life ends. Listen to this. In the book of Deuteronomy, in Deuteronomy chapter 32 and in verse 10 to 11, Moses reminds the children of Israel how God cared for them and guarded them, just like an eagle that stirs up the nests and hovers over its young, that spreads its wings to catch them and carries them on its pinions. Again in Exodus and in chapter 19 and in verse 4, God says He will carry the children of Israel on eagle's wings. I mean, they have been properly taken care of, nurtured. They have given the things they need, that they need as they grow. It's been provided. Parents who are listening today, our responsibility is to see that our children are in safe place. See to it that they go to school. Give a better education. We're so blessed here in America. The education is available. Education is are everywhere. I mean it, the school that you can go, at least finish your high school, and then you can apply for grants and if you want to pursue your course and go to college and get a degree. Or it's not really hard to find a job and look for a job and then study. But me as a dad, personally, if I would have my or enough money, I would not let my children work. I would really want to support them 100% until they finish their education. I remember my dad when he sent me to a university in a big city of Manila in the Philippines and provided me everything that I need. My mom and my dad, they especially my dad, he He wrote the power of attorney. He made the power of attorney so that I can get his salary in Manila or in the city where he keep on teaching as a school teacher, not receiving his salary, and I'm the one getting it because I've got my power of attorney to get his salary for 5 years. That's how my dad said, made a sacrifice for me so that I can get better education. Guys, listen, sometimes if we were really honest in our heart, we really don't want to grow when temptation comes. We get very complacent and satisfied with where we are, and any interruptions are viewed as negative. But God wants us to fly, to become all that He intends us to become. Amen. Everybody say amen. God wants you to fly. Tell your neighbor, God wants you to fly. God wants you to fly. Come on, tap their shoulder. Wake them up right now. Come on and tell them, hey, God wants you to fly. God don't want you to scratch the ground like the chicken. Keep on scratching and looking for something. And then poke, scratch, poke. No. The Lord wants us to fly and go up there. And how many miles you can see? You can see in a distance. You can see in a distance on how this eagle can catch his prey, and how he can catch his food for that day. The eagle can see a rabbit 2 miles away. Can you imagine that? If we will stay focused, if we will hold on to the promises of God, and if we will allow God to renew our mind, our hearts, our spirit, we will receive that long life that God had promised. Well, I don't know with other people that who dies very young. I don't know the dealings with the Lord. What I'm talking about is in my personal experience and in my personal desire and hopes and dreams that God will give me more life, that God will extend my life so that I can share the Word of God as long as I live. That's what I want to do, is to spread the Word of God. I will post the scriptures in Facebook and in social networking. I will not waste my time, not even to mention how God good in my life, to give glory and honor. And I believe in doing so, God will extend my life. I'm talking about myself. And that's what will be your prayer. And I don't know what your prayer is and about. In Psalms 103 in verse 5 says, who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. A time of renewal is necessary for every child of God. A time when we get rid of what is weighing us down, holding us back, aging us spiritually. We need to mature. We need to grow up. And not like a baby. It's not like a chicken always crawling and scratching the earth. You know, the dirt. And poking the food. And in a scratch and poke. Scratch. No. What we need to do is to grow and mature and have that understanding God has given us. A time to give up the sinful habits, to give up into the Holy Spirit in whatever way He is convicting us. We need to do this even to the point of renewal with pain. Do you hear that? And in Psalms 103 verse 5 says, who satisfies your desires with good things so that your youth is renewed like the eagle? It's a question. Who satisfies your desires with good things? Everybody say good things. Good things. Come on now. Say good things. Who satisfies and gives that good things so that your youth is renewed like an eagle? Could you imagine that? You can soar high. You can have that strength like an eagle. A time of renewal is necessary for every child of God. A time when we get rid of what is weighing us down, holding us back, aging us spiritually. Everybody say spiritual youthfulness. And when the eagles is free to soar in God's creation, they are the cleanest or the cleanest of birds. They were created to be free and to soar to great heights. They were not meant to remain close to the earth in the lowlands like other birds, like chicken, that the chickens will just scratch the dirt and poke something, look for something to eat, crawling on that ground. But the eagles can see in a distance of 2 miles. The eyes is too sharp to see that running rabbit right there for them to have their food for that day. Fresh meat. Because they were created to soar. Everybody say, I am created to soar. I am like an eagle created to soar. I am an eagle created to soar. They were created to soar. When eagles are held in captivity, they become one of the dirtiest bird. Did you hear that? If they were in captivity, they are not free. They become the dirtiest birds. God has created us to remain pure and holy and conformed to the image, or to the image of God, to His image. Don't allow the freedom we are to experience in Him to be compromised by spending too much time in worldly thinking. Do we hear that? Don't allow, let me read it again, say it again to you guys. Listen, for I'm talking to myself too. Don't allow the freedom we are to experience in Him to be compromised. Everybody say compromised. By spending too much time in worldly thinking, activities, and mindsets. Remain clean. Everybody say remain clean. Come on, church. Say remain clean. What do you mean by that? The Bible said God is holy. He is holy. And we cannot see God unless we become holy. Apostle Paul says in the book of Philippians, I was reading in the New Testament, it's talking about those people in Philippi. I am holy. God is holy. And you cannot see God endless unless you become holy. That's what God is telling for us to remain clean. Everybody say amen. I will conclude in this, and I want us to have music if JV can come and help us. Anybody who's here, a musician, maybe Israel. Eagles do not fly like other birds. Like I have mentioned a while ago, comparing to a chicken. They don't flap their wings, but rather soar. Flapping their wings would use incredible amounts of their strength, or their own strength and endurance, and they would require so much more food and fuel if they didn't soar. Instead, they sit on a high ledge and wait for the right wind current to come. Ooh, that's beautiful. There's something implies there. They wait for the wind, the current of the wind. They know where the wind goes. They know where the wind comes from. And they know how to soar with the help of the wind. Can you imagine that? The wind that represents for us today as the Holy Spirit. We're waiting for the moment, for the move of the Holy Spirit. And then when the Holy Spirit moves, that's the time we were supposed to move. Unless there's no Holy Spirit, and unless there's no wind, the eagles don't want to fly, and he cannot soar. That's why he knows how to use his wings. He spread out his 2 meters wings and soar in the air and wait for that wind. When the time is right, they take off and soar upward effortlessly.
Woo!
That's beautiful. I like that. Effortlessly. Let me just feel that for a moment. Effortlessly. When the Holy Spirit is guiding you, you didn't have to make things happen. We'll just wait for the Holy Spirit. God will open the door for you. God will allow you to enter in to His rests. Wait for that wind. Wait for that wind so that you can soar up high. Amen. They take off and soar upward effortlessly because they have waited. Everybody say, have waited. They have waited. Come on, tap the shoulder of someone next to you. They have waited and waited so patiently. Don't be in a hurry. And you become a Christian today and you thought you can soar up high right away. No, there's a waiting time. I was talking to Maine and Trey the other day, you know, about Daniel and Caleb. And I was so blessed. I was so happy for them to be part of the youth ministry. And they're the ones leading the youth. And they have the capability of doing this. Yes, we made mistakes. They're still young at their age or for their age to do that. But these two girls, two of my daughters, they saw us do the ministry for years. They were born in the church. And they saw us, we saw our mistakes, they saw our mistakes, they saw our frustration, they saw everything about the ministry, everything that's talking about the ministry. How my wife and I move forward, soar up high. And we didn't even bother of what the people will say. Of what's happening in our family, of our ministry and everything that God has given us. We'll just move on. Whether we have good, big congregation, whether we have a few people in the church, it doesn't matter to me anymore. Whether we have money or we don't have money, because I know God is our provider. He will take care of us. That's how we depend our hopes and trusts to the Lord. Amen. There is a special upgoing wind that they ride as it circles higher and higher towards the sky. They know that. The eagles know that. There's a up high, the guiding wind that will help them to soar up high. And they know the timing. How fascinating is that? And I think as a Christian, there's something that we need to learn and waited for the Holy Spirit to move in behalf of us. And that wind will guide us up high. Amen. Amen. So today, what lesson for God's children to learn? How often do we waste strength by jumping out too soon and flapping our wings instead of waiting for God's timing? Let's pause for a moment for us to understand. How many times? I know I'm guilty of that. There's so many times in being in the 25, 28 years in the ministry. I mean, there's so many things that I've tried and spent my own energy and try everything under the sun just to grow this ministry and to help God. And you know, I don't need to help God. God, I need His help. Nobody should help God. And He's God. He doesn't need help. We need His help. Amen. Wait for your right time. I remember our friend from Phoenix. Oh, by the way, we are already friends as I talk and speak about this story and tell this story. The pastor that I will be going there, invited me to sing in his church and minister to his church. And he's the one who told me about about this story, Danny, there will come a time that when the spotlight's focused on you, do your best to the Lord and wait for that right time. God will give you the perfect timing to do that. And when it will happen, I don't know. And how it will happen, I don't know. But I believe in my heart, one of these days it will happen. But I just keep on waiting. Like what I'm telling to my two daughters, for Daniel and Kayla. I've been praying and praying and tried to push them, and even Israel. But one day, I was so excited. They're the one who wants to lead the worship. They're the one who lead the youth. I've waited for that prayer for many years, and now they're doing it. Yes, they are not perfect. They will make mistakes, but God allows them to do that. And God spoke to my heart and allowed them to do the youth ministry. And the lesson here, guys, there is a time when there will be a time for you. Each one of us. There will be time for you, JV. There will be time for you, Israel. There will be time for you, Maine and Trey. God will call you. There will be time for you, Mary Jane, if you're... There will be time for you, Rita. There will be time for you, Gigi, to stand up, Lorraine. God will use you. God will each one of you. Because we're born as an eagle. God will be born as a leader. And I believe as we move on, God will allow us for all these challenges, testing and trials to happen in our lives. But God will use us. He will be the one to set us up. There will be a timing, the right wind that will carry us up so that we can soar up high in the sky. Amen. But when we wait on the Lord, wait for His timing, wait for His answers, wait for His direction, then we can soar to new heights and fly to new places. Those who wait on the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint. Are we blessed today? Are we blessed today? Thank you so much for listening. Let me pray for you. Father, I thank you so much for my brothers, my sisters. Please bow your head and I will give blessing to each one of you. Lord, I thank you that you will open that windows for them, Lord. Lord, favor from people. Lord, thank you so much as they will obey you. Lord, as they focus their eyes unto you, Lord. They will not grow weary or not faint, Lord, but they will soar like an eagle. Their strength will be renewed. Thank you so much, God, that you will move in our behalf today. We just praise you and bless you. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praises. We give you all the honor, oh God. Thank you so much that you will touch them, that you will bless them. Lord, touch their hearts today. Lord, fill them with your power and your anointing. Thank you so much, God, that you will give them all the things that they need for their renewal, for their strength to be renewed, oh God. For the power of the Holy Spirit that will clothe them, oh God, that will empower them today. I give you glory and I give you praises. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. And everybody say, amen and amen.